The platform blast aftermath, including updates on the conditions of the four burn victims and a look at the recovery and cleanup efforts.
But we begin in the Gulf of Mexico, where WDSU reporter Blake Hansen shows us the blast damage from the water.
Well, these are the closest images we are getting of that damaged platform here. You can see it right behind me. Very charred corner. This is the southeast corner of this platform here, where the fire was mostly contained here. We are on board a crew ship, the Anita B, and this was actually about 3 miles, rather, from this explosion when it happened. I actually talked with a crew member that was looking at the platform when the explosion happened and described it as a ball of flames. This boat that we are on and many other boats in that area immediately responded to this to get here, and were informed that there might be a missing person in the water. They are still, as sun begins to set, looking for two people in the water in this area. But as I look up onto this platform right now, I can actually see people that are standing on that that damaged part, the charred part of there. You can see some melted metal. Just the guardrails to the edge there is actually caved in. A crane is actually bent down from the intense flames caused by the damage of this platform. So you can see this is was a very tense fire is at this portion. And while this fire was going on, those that were escaping actually were going to the other side. I can actually show you over on this other side of the platform, there is a helicopter pad that some of the people that were trying to escape went to. Helicopters were able to land, evacuate those people. We know at least 11 people medevaced from this location. But these are the closest images we are getting right now of the damage on this platform. And at this moment, as the sun goes down, they are still searching. Still heard calls out over the radio to search for two missing people that were believed to have been aboard that platform. We are on your side aboard the Anita B ship. Blake Hansen, WDSU News.